which is a worldwide Anglican movement of women, bringing together women of all backgrounds and rooted in prayer. Please follow our traditional service in the white booklets called Evensong. And the choir will now sing Psalms 47 and 48, which are appointed for the ninth evening of the month. You may like to follow the words in the small black books of common prayer from page 473.
Oh, thou who hast to care for The book of Proverbs, the 12th chapter, beginning at the 13th verse. The evil are ensnared by the transgression of their lips, but the righteous escape from trouble. From the fruit of the mouth, one is filled with good things, and manual labor has its reward. Fools think their own ways right, but the wise listen to advice. Fools show their anger at once, but the prudent ignore an insult. Whoever speaks the truth gives honest evidence, but a false witness speaks deceitfully. Rash words are like sword thrusts, but the tongue of a wise brings healing. Truthful lips endure forever, but a lying tongue lasts only a moment. Deceit is in the mind of those who plan evil, but those who counsel peace have joy. No harm happens to the righteous, but the wicked are filled with trouble. Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord, but those who act faithfully are his delight. One who is clever conceals knowledge, but the mind of a fool broadcasts from.
found here about whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph, from Nazareth. Nathanael said to him, Can anything good come out of Nazareth? Philip said to him, Come and see. When Jesus saw Nathanael coming towards him, he said to him, Here is truly an Israelite in whom there is no deceit. Nathanael asked Jesus, Where did you come to know him? Jesus answered, I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you. Nathanael replied, Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel. Jesus answered, Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than these. And he said to him, Very truly I tell you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending Jesus saw him as a man without deceit, in sharp contrast to the patriarch Israel, who gave the nation its identity, having stolen his brother's birthright by deceit. The new people that Jesus is building will inherit the vision of angels which the patriarch was given. Over this house, again, the angels ascend and descend, as we pour wine and break bread, as we listen to the word of God, scriptures read, as we look in our neighbor's faces with the eyes of Christ our friend. And so, Father, we pray, the power of your love, which we know in our worship, in the presence of your Son, the transforming gift of your Spirit. Through that love, continue your saving work in us. Give us courage and our way. Bring us to the joys you promise. Silence.